Do you want budget Hackintosh for 4K video editing, built from brand new components and ready for massive feature upgrades? Then this video is the right for you! Hi, I'm Teresa from Morgonaut.cloud and I help people to save money on their Hackintosh builds. I help them simply to build a perfect Hackintosh. If you are new here, then please click that subscribe button and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. The people who are in touch with me already for some time knows I build Hackintoshes of all categories, from ultra cheap based on old components up to monster brand new top spec builds, like now my last build is this Intel Core i9-9900K Hackintosh Monster. But I'm getting a lot of comments about how to build really affordable Hackintosh for 4K video editing, which users can easily upgrade in the future even to the mentioned i9-9900K. So, I decided to build such a cheap Hackintosh based on brand new components just for purpose of this video, but then I fell in love with it and now I use this Hackintosh primarily for all my video recordings. So, now let's jump straight into the specs and what components I chose and recommend. I chose the ASUS Prime Z370A motherboard because it is, by my opinion, one of the most compatible mainboards for any Hackintosh build. And it even supports Thunderbolt 3. You can expand RAM up to 64GB and CPU support goes up to Intel Core i9-9900K. So you are absolutely not limited by this board in any aspect, and the same board you can reuse for your next upgrade to a monster Hackintosh sometime in future. For CPU, I chose the Intel Core i3-8350K, which is the cheapest, easy overclockable CPU with 4 cores and high frequency, and Intel HD 630 integrated GPU, which will help with encoding acceleration using Intel QuickSync technology. Now I can hear you. Core i3 CPU for video editing? Are you kidding? So, wait till I show you its real-life performance later in this video. What surprised me was the fact this Core i3 CPU has about 60% of performance of my Intel Core i7-8700K, but for just about one third of the price. So I started to use this machine also for all my video encodings. Yes, again, you can hear it right. i3 CPU for video encoding. Am I a loser? So those are the most important parts. For RAM, I chose just 2 4GB sticks of some cheap 2800MHz memory, so in total 8GB of RAM. And yes, I can hear you again. What? Only 8GB of RAM for 4K video editing? As I said, wait! Yes, you are right. It is really recommended to have at least 16GB of RAM for video editing. In my main production machine, I have 64GB of RAM. But we are talking now about budget 4K video editing Hackintosh. And this little baby can handle it even with only the 8GB with ease. And finally, for storage, I chose very affordable Samsung 970 EVO 256GB NVMe M.2 drive. And I forget to mention GPU, I chose again very affordable Sapphire AMD RX 580 8GB Nitro Plus version, which is 100% compatible with macOS and is running great in the latest macOS Mojave. By the way, if you want to build also similar system, just look at this video description, there you can see links to all components I used. And because I always try to make Hackintosh easily available to all people, even absolute beginners without any knowledge how to build a Hackintosh, in this video description you can also find link to already prepared and tweaked EFI Clever folder. So all you need to do is to just follow my tutorial, link is again under this video, install macOS on your disk, and then just copy my whole prepared EFI folder into EFI partition. That's all. You can have your own perfect Hackintosh up and running in just an hour. First, I will show you some synthetic benchmarks, and then I will show you the point of this video, how it performs in 4K video editing, and some conclusion. So, synthetic benchmarks. First, let's have a look at about this Mac. Latest macOS Mojave, 4GHz Intel Core i3, 8GB of RAM and RX 580 GPU. Onboard audio is fully working, as well the Intel Ethernet. RX580 metal supported. Samsung 970 EVO NVMe M.2 disk drive. All USB ports correctly mapped and working on advertised speeds. So let's run now the Geekbench benchmark. ...5,461 single-core performance and 17,090 multi-core performance. Let's check now the GPU compute benchmark in OpenCL. ...143,080 points OpenCL score. Let's check the Metal performance now. ...142,252 Metal score. Now let's go to the Cinebench benchmark CPU and GPU. ...668 points is not so impressive, but the strength of the CPU is somewhere else than 3D rendering. You'll see that later in this video. Let's check now the OpenGL benchmark. Quiet 125 FPS, that's very good. So I enabled back all my monitoring utilities, which I disabled to not influence the benchmarks. Intel SpeedStep working, so power management is working okay. Also sleep and wake is okay. All sensors and monitoring tools completely working. Also the same for GPU power management. So let's open the DaVinci Resolve. I prepared some 4K test project based on RED files, which are converted from their 6 to 8K resolution to 4K. So, when you look here, all files are exact 4K footage and they are in 4K timeline. All clips have same color correction applied and added a lot, and some of them have few more nodes with additional corrections. So scrubbing in timeline is absolutely fluid with not a single slowdown. You can look at the GPU usage and also check the CPU usage at the same time. Absolutely no dropped frames. Real-time playback exactly at 24 FPS, that means real-time. CPU usage around 44%. So let's render it out. Most of you will publish to YouTube, so I choose YouTube and H.264. And now that's interesting. As you can see, the CPU usage and the GPU usage are at its maximum. That means we are fully utilizing both at the same time, so there is no bottleneck in the system. Rendering is twice as fast as a real-time playback. So this build is what I would call a perfectly balanced system. So let's try export it into ProRes 422 HQ. And again, same scenario. Absolutely maxed out every portion of this build. CPU temperature stays in high 50s even with the cheap air cooler. I absolutely love this build. Nice performance for cheap, and also the low power consumption is a very nice benefit. Now back to what I mean by the perfectly balanced system. Absolutely does not matter if you have top spec high-end CPU, high-end GPU, but poor disk. The same in reverse. It's pointless to have the best GPU, but the rest not on par. The key is balance. The whole system must be balanced, so any of its components is not a bottleneck. So, as you could see, none of the components in this build was a bottleneck. Better GPU with this CPU would not help in any way. And also better CPU with this GPU would not help too. This is what I call perfectly balanced budget 4K video editing Hackintosh. So again, just a reminder, links to all components used in this Hackintosh and also already prepared and tweaked EFI Clever folder configuration, you can find now in this video description. So, as you could see, you absolutely don't need to spend thousands of dollars on a Hackintosh to be able to edit and render 4K videos. Even with a low budget, you can go and buy brand new components and build of it a perfect Hackintosh for 4K video editing. And you can easily upgrade it in future. So, I hope you found in my today's video some new inspiration. If so, please click on the like button below. Share my videos anywhere you can so more people can benefit from it. Subscribe to my channel and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. And don't forget, I don't have only one single video. I've done a lot of useful videos and tutorials already, so watch them too before asking. You can also join my Hackintosh and Macintosh groups on Facebook, Reddit or my website. Links are again now in this video description. So, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time, my Hackintosh friends.